Greetings folks, welcome back to my channel. And today our vintage scooter has undergone some serious difficulty, I guess. There is some trouble with electronics, or maybe, I don't know, carburetor. It's not really starting pretty well. I have to kick it like, you know, 5 to 10 times, and then only it, you know, comes to life. So we figured it out that there was no problem with electronics. That is, the spark strength was good and other things was working pretty well. However, we found out that there was a little overflow problem, and the culprit was this pin. If you can see it, let me focus. Okay, so what has happened to my camera? Okay, so there's a tiny groove at the top of this cone, and owing to that, you can see it. See that? It's pretty minuscule. You can't really, you know, observe without closely watching it. You can see this groove, right? So that was the reason that it was not really functioning and there was an overflow issue. So the further detail is not really that, you know, complex. The thing is, like, we simply have to change it with a new one, and the new one is not... That would cost nearly $1 if you are in USA, and maybe more in some other country. So the thing is, like, simply you have to buy that and you have to replace it. We just bought it, a separate in your unit, and we have replaced the same over here. See that? So that's where the float has gone. Next thing is obviously to place it back at its place inside the carburetor over here, and then we'll be tightening it. So it's just a video to let you know what the basic problems are when you are starting a Vespa, and if things like this small goes bad, basically. So now that everything is set, we'll take our first trial. Start karna. That is it. Problem sorted. Okay, so I won't really be going into the nitty-gritty of how to do it and stuff like that, cause it's a pretty simple exercise. You can do it on your own. Just this video was to let you guys know about such a problem should it occur in your scooter. You must consider replacing this pin, or the float pin as they call it. So that would be all, folks. That's what the thing about vintage scooter, or for that matter any bike, is you learn a new thing every day. So stay tuned for more. Till the next time, build it, ride it.